बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर एबल टू लिसन टू मी एंड माय वॉइस इज क्लियर। ओके, आई होप दैट ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टडिंग एट होम एंड गिविंग ए प्रॉपर टाइम टू योर स्टडीज। एंड आई होप दैट वट एवर वी हैव लर्नड इन HTML यू वुड हैव अप्लाइड एंड the files which were given to you last time, the things which were explained to you, just like how to insert image, how to use HTML language to design a web page. So we will continue the same chapter, which is basically right now we are doing, and we were on page number, I think, structure we have done. Line break we had done up to here. Okay, cascade style sheets. Yes, I think we had started the cascade style sheets last time. Yeah, so we have to do the cascade style sheets, and with this this chapter will also be completed, and we will start the next chapter. We will see the activities which are given as a practical lab activity as well. So cascade style sheet, this was the code that we did last time. How we can apply the style, how, what kind of a style is there that I have applied to it? If you go there, you right click on it and you go and see the coding, open with the notepad, so you'll be able to see the coding, that what is basically meant by the style sheet. Style we mention inside the head section. Okay, inside the head section, this is the head section, here is the head section, or over there we have mentioned this style. This is the style. What style? Whenever we mention style, first we type style type text or cascade style sheet. Cascade style sheet is basically its name when we are going to apply some particular style. So over here we have applied one style to the body, background color pink. So we had applied this style to our page, that when we will set this background color. So over here you can see that the background color is pink, which is being appeared over here. So such kind of style which is going to be applied to overall page, we mention it over here in the head section with the style tag. Fine, I hope now this thing is clear. So last time up to here we had done. Fine, now what we are going to do, so we had seen this method, that how we can mention the style sheets, how we can embed styles using style tag. Now background properties, what are the different properties that we can set? Just like background color, normally we set background color or background image. So we can put some color or image, we can insert the images as well. So over here we have made one background color. Afterwards some tricky terms are there, so I will give you one homework for this chapter. But now the homework will be given to you through the Elmversity software. Okay, so what will happen, that you are going to have, I will also upload it in the Google Classroom, don't you worry. But now onward I am going to give you the homework through the Elmversity software, so you will have the homework section, just like I have got the homework manager, but you will have the homework section. So what chapter we are studying, just like today we are right now we are studying the, I am giving you chapter 9 is what is the name of the chapter, introduction to HTML. okay, introduction to HTML. fine, what you have to do, I am giving you define, write down following work in your books. Define the following terms. What are the terms that you are going to define? Home page, what is meant by home page? What is meant by HTML tags? HTML attributes. Home page, HTML tag, HTML attributes. Okay. So we will do the question and answer as well, and I will upload the question and answers as well in the same way. So one student started this today, and it you can write down these definition in one day. Fine, no particular specific time I am not allocating, but one day is I think enough. So you will be able to have one notification. You will receive one notification that this is a work. You have to write down in your notebooks. So can anyone please check it in the university and let me know about it, that you are able to see that this is the homework which is given to you. Any student, just go and check in the university and then let me know by raising the hand. If you have installed in your cell phone, you would have received one notification as well. Anyway, we come to the next point over here in the chapter. What are the practical activities? Let me check over here, because practical lab activities are also important. We need to know. Farhan has to create a simple web page on the topic our national bird. Set an image of the bird as the background. Help him create the web page and set suitable properties. Okay. Then view the page in web browser. So this is the lab activity that I'm going to explain you right now. Can anyone please raise the hand and let me know? No one has received. Mehak. Yes, will you?
Yes, sir.
It is received?
Yes, sir.
Fine, good. Okay, I will take Aisha.
Yes, sir.
It is visible?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay, fine. I think now this is enough. So Farhan has to create a simple web page in the topic national bird. Fine. Set an image of the bird as the background. Help him. Now we have seen about this background, that how we are going to set the background. We have seen these properties which are written over here, background properties. Okay, since that though two pages were actually not available, so that background properties image is not there, but you can go through this thing through the book. You can go through it. So we will make one web page over here. What we are going to do, I am going to open, let's suppose this one. Fine. So I am going to view source. This is the page that I am using right now. We have to give one background, one image over here. I am going to make another web page, but in order to save the time, I would like to make the file from here by saving it. Save as lab one. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to find out one image, or we can find out multiple images of the birds that we are going to use in our work. When I click over here, so I can see over here multiple images are available for the birds. I can right click, I can take any one or two that I have taken. I am going to right click on it. I am going to store it in the folder where I am working. I am working in this folder, chapter number 9. Okay, bird. I have saved it with the name of bird 1. I have saved this image as well with the name of bird 2. This is a PNG image, that is a JPG image, that is a JPG image, so it doesn't matter at all. Okay. Just give me okay. So over here we have to insert, if we need to insert the image, how can we insert the image? What is the procedure to insert the image? We had seen this thing over here, how to insert image in your work. View source. We can set image by writing image source, and we will give the URL of the image. You can see over here, the procedure of giving the image is mentioned. And we had gone through it, where we had mentioned image source. Just let me show you another file for it. Okay, I have copied this file over here just to save the time. Otherwise, I would have to type the complete code. Now, over here, you can see over there that when we have inserted the image, we write the image source. Okay, this is the image source that we normally write. Okay, so these are the lines that we are going to write, and we must have that particular image in the same folder where we need to insert the image in our work. Just like over here, I want to insert one image over here after breaking the row. Fine. So image source flower.jpg, but I have got one bird.jpg, bird one. With the name of bird 1. Fine. Image source bird2.jpg. Alt image is not available. If the image is not found, what we are going to write? Alt. If the image is not found or the browser is not supporting that particular image, so what we are going to do? We are going to write this statement, alternate. Okay, alt for alternate. Alternate, this statement will appear if the image is not supported with the web browser. Where we have written this statement? In the body section. Fine, we'll go to file, we will save it, and now we go and we see the output of the lab one. Lab one icon is not appearing as a web browser. Why? Because I did not save it with .html. I have to save it lab1.html. Okay, now I think. Now you can see over here, this is the image that I have inserted in my document. But second image is not appearing. And over here, what is written? It is written that image is not available, second image. What was the image that I inserted? Image name was bird2.jpg. Bird2.jpg is not appearing. What is the problem? We need to find out. Image one is appearing, bird1.jpg is appearing, but bird2 is not appearing. Is there any difference in the spelling? Bird1, bird2 without space. So there isn't any difference in the spelling. Yes, Bill Bershire, Bilkis, who is going?
Sir, because the image is PNG and you have written
good,
JPG.
Good, very good point. Yeah, that is the reason. Fine. Image is basically over here having different extension. That's why I wanted to show you this example that when the image is not found, I have written that alternate. If the image is not found, print this message. This message is being printed. Why? Image is there. But we have not mentioned the extension correctly. How we can check our extension? Right click on it, go there, go to properties. Image one is having the extension .jpg. Right click on this image. When I had saved at that time, I had told you that this is a PNG image. So PNG image is also supportable. It supports, but since we did not mention it properly, the extension was not mentioned properly, hence the result is not coming. So what we are going to do, we are going to mention over here bird2.png, bird2.png. Fine, this thing is clear now. I close it, I say yes. Now I go and check, refresh it. First image is coming over here. Second image is coming over here. My images were not that much large as these images are. Why? We have set image as background. Why? How we have set it? Because over here in this coding, if you will go and you'll see what we have actually done over here in this coding. If you see over there, the images that I had taken through the internet, these were not that much large. These are normal images in a reasonable size. But in my output, the images are coming at the complete page. Why? Because I have applied one option over here. See over here in the Qiskit style sheet, what is mentioned? Body, background image, background attachment is fixed. So whatever we will give the image, it will be fixed as attachment. Fine. So background attachment we have fixed over here. So that's why you are able to see that the image is coming as an attachment. Okay. Come to the next point. What was the problem statement? That we have to make our work in the lab activity. We are actually going through the lab activity. Our national bird, set an image of the bird as the, okay, we have to mention something about our national bird. So we can go and we can take the text from here, Google, our national, I should write, I think Pakistan. So we are going to have, this is basically the Pakistan national bird. Anyway, you can take its image, but I have not taken, I'm going to just paste some text over here. So you have to take this image, okay? Chakor image. Chakor is the, Chukar is the official, bird of Pakistan. Fine, I take some text from here, I come over here, right click on it, open with, open notepad, and I'm just going to put this text instead of this IP address and all these things. You can also apply the break row, okay? Otherwise it is not going to be applied the break row. And over here I am mentioning heading our national bird. Close the heading, save it, and you will give the relevant text, okay? So you'll be able to have this heading on national bird. Fine, so come to the next one. Rabia has learned to create web page in HTML. She has now been assigned to create a web page on the school sports activities. Set the background color as pink and use the activities that your school offers to create the text. So what you have to do, you have to do it at your own. Just how to set the background color, I have explained you. I set the background color as pink. I think in one of the sheets, I had applied this one. Yeah, background color is pink. So I'm going to give you these files as well, okay? These files I'm going to give you, upload in your Google Classroom. You have to make the page and you have to make show their school activity. So you will take the pictures from these school activities. For example, you will go to the Google and find out some PSM. I think in university you are going to have the pictures as well. PSM activities. I think it is something else. PSM Pakistan school. So you are going to have some images and you are going to use those images in your work. Okay, take some images from here and use these images in your work. Fine. Okay, so it is your assignment. Point number two. Number three is Faiza has to create a web page on the topic historical places that I like. Which are the historical places that impress you the most? Create an HTML document in Notepad on this topic. Save it and view it in web browser. Include a short description of each of the place. So you will take three web pages, three images. Fine, you will go there, for example, historical place. You can take three historical place from just like Badshahi Mosque, Lahore. Fine. You will take the image of Badshahi Mosque. Save image. I'm saving in. I'm just writing Badshahi Masjid. Okay, only two letters. Then I need the description as well. So when you will click over there, you will have some description. Take a short description of it, okay, that you are going to use in your work. Fine. Take a short description and also save it in one of your files. Similarly, you will have to do it for the, just like I'm saving over here. This is a short description. So what you are going to do, you will make the, I'm going to show you this in this way. This is lab activity number three. So we are going to use lab3.html. Fine. So over here you will mention lab3.html. So what is the thing that I'm going to take? I'm going to take one image of Badshahi Masjid. My what is my image name? Badshahi Masjid. Okay. I will give the description over here. Writing over here. Fine. And the description that I have copied from the internet, I have pasted. You can apply the break row over here, BR. Wherever you will give the BR, you are going to break the row. Next image, take another image over here. Let's suppose I go there on the Google, just giving you the example. I type Mohenjo-daro. It is a historical place in Pakistan. So I will take one description given over here. Okay, I copy it. I will take one image, only one image is I think more than enough. Open the image, save it. I'm going to save it in my folder with the name of only two letters, Mohenjo MD. Okay. It is a JPEG image. I'm going to write over here. So I will give over here. And I'm going to type one description as well. I have pasted the description. What I'm going to do, I have given one heading as well. I'm going to copy this heading and I'm going to paste it over here. What I'm writing now, this time. Okay, in the same way you will insert one more image. I have inserted only two. Fine, this thing is clear. I will save it. Save. I will now open this page, lab 3. Where is the lab 3? Here is the lab 3. I will go to double click. Can you see the description? The line is coming over here, you know. So we can apply one break row over here, one break row over here, then it will become a paragraph. You can also change the image size. Image size is right now. It is a normal image size that we copied from the internet. That image size that we are using right now. This image size. But we can change the image size as well by defining the number of pixels for the length and the breadth. Fine. You have to take three historical places. I have taken two only. I hope this phenomena is not clear. This thing is not clear. This is one historical place, Badshahi Mosque, and this is second historical place, Mohenjo-daro. You will take in the same way. You will take the third historical place. One heading, one image, source, then description. Fine. I hope this thing is clear. We move to the next one. Now we see over here what is written in the fourth topic. Which is your favorite outdoor game? Write an HTML document to create a web page on your favorite sports activity. Also set an appropriate image as the background and set properties for the image. Sports activity. So on a sports activity, you will find out some images, but before going towards that, let me mark the attendance. From Adin to Sayyid FIFA Faisal. Okay, fine. So what we are actually going to do, we will write over here sports activities. You will find out your sports activity, whatever you like. I'm going to close the extra tab pages over here. Okay, we have to take some good sports activities images over here. that we are going to use in our work. We can take any image, this one or this one. Okay, such kind of activity we take. I'm going to save it sportsactivity.html. Now, so I'm going to open this file. File save as lab4.html. I will give you these files in your Google Classroom, okay? Fine. So what I'm going to do over here right now, I'm going to take sportsactivity.jpg. Only one image right now I'm using. You can use a number of images. Take some paragraph about sports activities. Okay. So how would we are going to take, we can take some bullet points or numberings, but bullet points are not going to appear in the same way. So you may face some problem because we have some other mechanism to insert bullets and numberings. Okay, sports, we take one paragraph from here. And we copy this paragraph because we want to give some description about this. So I am going to type this over here. Now the line is too lengthy. So what I am going to do, I am going to apply some breaks. Fine. I can apply just like I can give one break row over here. Okay. After some characters, I can give some break row over here. BR is the break row. We had discussed about it in our last classes. Break row. We can give one break row over here. Okay, since the paragraph is lengthy, so anyway, you will manage it at your own. So I have just explained you this thing, that how you are going to deal when the paragraph is lengthy, so you can break the rows according to your requirement. Fine. Okay, so now I'm going to save this lab activity number 4. I'm going to see the output by double clicking this. It is showing us the HTML heading. I think it was because I have saved the file as, that's why it is showing us. otherwise there should not be no HTML heading. Yes, this one, this heading is not required. We can press Ctrl S. We can press F5 to refresh. Okay, so in this way we can make break rows. Wherever I applied BR, now the text is coming in the next rows. So what was the objective basically? Which is your favorite outdoor game? Write an HTML document to create a web page for your favorite sports activity. Also set an appropriate image as the background and set background properties for the image. Okay. So afterwards, there are the question and answers are there, but today we have not done the question and answer, but I have just given you a short homework in your university. I will also paste that to homework in your Google Classroom as well. Okay. So in your Google Classroom, I'm also mentioning the homework, which is write the following definitions in your copies. This is for this chapter, and we had given you HTML tags. Home page, and I think HTML attributes. Yes. These were the three. Okay, can anyone just check in the university and can confirm me, because I have also pasted it over here. Homepage, HTML tags, HTML attributes. Okay, fine. So I hope all these things are clear. I hope so. And you will also get these files. I am going to upload these files as well for you. Which files? All these that we have done. Fine. Here are the files. So in this chapter, we have taken these images, okay, and we have made last time, since I had not given, so lab activities I am also giving you. Four lab activities are also complete. So you are going to have these, and video of this lesson will also be attached. Fine. Thank you so much, all of you. I hope all of you have understood all these points, and I hope you're going to do practice for it. Thank you so much.